Welcome back to another video. Today we are looking at the Panasonic Lumix G100. I'm filming it right now. I'm just holding it handheld because this is a great vlogging system. It's perfect for anyone who wants to get into vlogging, maybe upgrading from a smartphone, maybe looking to really take vlogging to a next level, or just to have a good vlogging system that they can use easily, you know. And that's something that's interesting about this camera. It's very easy to use, very straightforward to set up and get going. But let's talk about why it's good for video in general before we get on to the specifics that make it a good vlogging system. So there's a few things that make this a great system for video. First of all, as you'd probably expect, it can shoot 4K at up to 30 frames a second. You also got that full HD up to 120 frames a second as well for that super slow motion, which can really add a lot to your videos. But something that makes this camera really, really handy, especially for vlogging, is the hybrid 5-axis image stabilization that they've got in the camera. So it combines optical image stabilization and electronic image stabilization to give you this really good system for handheld shooting. You know, you can use it for handheld, use it while walking along vlogging, or just shooting handheld generally, and you can get nice, smooth footage. It's got Vlog L built into the camera, which makes it great for getting that extra dynamic range, that wider dynamic range, and of course for color grading in post. So if you're using this camera as part of a kind of a bigger video system, so maybe you've got a main camera using this as a B camera, you can shoot in that Vlog L. So that's great. It's a great thing to have in there for more kind of advanced users. And then you've got the features that you'd probably expect, like time-lapse and stop motion built into the camera, stuff you'd expect from a Panasonic camera at this point. But one of the things that really sets this camera apart, and especially in terms of vlogging, and what makes it so easy to set up and use as a vlogger or as someone coming from a smartphone, is what they're calling OZO Audio. Now, I hope I'm saying that right. It might be OZO, but certainly OZO Audio, that's what I'm gonna go with. And essentially, this is three internal microphones that work together to actually capture really clear and crisp audio from the right source. You've got a front-facing mic, a rear-facing mic, which is handy, especially if you're filming like this, but you wanna be talking over that as well. And then a kind of surround mic as well, which is able to pick up the kind of the ambient noise of your surroundings. But they work together to actually track your voice. So it'll actually use the face and eye autofocus detection to track where you are in the frame and make sure that the right mic is picking you up. And it actually works really well. It means you can speak from behind the camera, in front of the camera, or get that kind of all around ambient noise if you actually want to do that. Now you can control it yourself. You can tell it exactly what you want it to do, or you can just let it go on auto mode, which I found works particularly well. And this means that of course you can plug in an external mic, there's a jack to do that as well, but you don't necessarily have to. And that takes a lot of the hassle out of setting this up. You could literally just walk out of the house with it like this and be able to capture some great vlogs.
So let's talk a little bit more about what makes this camera perfect for vlogging in particular. And obviously I'm back on the G100 now. So I've got face and eye detection on, so it's tracking me around the frame, and it's using that audio to actually track my voice and pick that up on the internal microphones. Now, one of the cool things about this, as soon as you flip the screen around to face yourself, like I've got now, it automatically enters into video selfie mode, which means that a few different things happen. If you're shooting in auto exposure, then the camera automatically increases the depth of field so you can see more of your surroundings. Face and eye autofocus also just kick in so that it can follow you around the frame and it can make sure it's doing that. Like I say as well, the audio tracking kicks in as well. So it's using the face and eye auto detection like that to actually track my voice as well. It'll be able to track that based on where I am in the frame, which is obviously based on the eye detection, the face detection as well. A couple of other things that make this super nice to actually vlog with. As soon as you hit record, a big red border comes up around the screen on the actual screen, which I can see myself in. And that just lets me know that I am recording. And I know that sounds like a tiny little thing, but especially if you're just getting into this, there would definitely be times where you think you're recording, you do a whole piece to camera, and then it turns out you're not recording, which is horrible. I've definitely done that before. And that's a horrible thought. It's a horrible thing when that happens. So just having a big, massive red border around the screen makes it super clear that you are recording. Now, I'm actually using the grip with the camera to actually film myself. And that actually has a couple of different controls in it. So it just connects to the camera via a little wire. And it has a couple of controls, one to hit record and one to actually take a shot. And that makes it super easy to film myself right now because it just, the camera itself is really light anyway, but it just means that I'm able to hold the grip instead of the camera and just this whole vlogging experience is super easy. Now, I was going to be walking around. It is extremely bright in the sun. That's why I'm doing it just here. But we're going to go and test the 5-axis image stabilization as well, just to see how that does with the walking shot. So if you can vlog and walk. Okay, so I found a good spot where I can test out the image stabilization. So a bit of shade, and we can walk around while vlogging, just to see how, first of all, how the image stabilization is performing. It looks to be super smooth in the screen, but also how that voice tracking is working, how the audio is working, because I'm just using the built-in microphone here. I'm no longer in my garden. You know, there's traffic over that way. There's all kinds of sounds, there's birds. There might be a little bit of wind. So we'll see how that is working as well, just using the built-in microphones in the camera. Now, while we've been talking about this camera as more of a video-centric system, and certainly aimed more towards vlogging, there's no slouch for photography as well. You've actually got a 20.3 megapixel sensor in there. That's with no low pass filter. The detail is actually really, really nice. I was able to capture some nice stuff. Certainly shooting in RAW, you get a nice dynamic range. I was really happy with the photos I was getting. Nice and crisp, nice and clear. I've just been using the 12 to 32, which is kind of roughly a 24 to 64 mil on a 35 mil equivalent. And that's been working absolutely great. That's kind of a great all-rounder lens. You've got that face and eye autofocus, which works really well and makes taking portraits much, much easier, including self-portraits as well. And as you'd expect from a Panasonic camera, you've got post-focus and focus stacking, which works just as well as it does in loads of other Panasonic cameras and is a really nice feature to have in the camera. Now let's talk a little bit about the design and the actual build of this camera as well. So you've got a nice 3-inch free-angle touchscreen, which works really well for controlling things. Actually, I've been changing the shutter speed and things like that on the screen, but also just to be able to see yourself. It's nice and bright, so it works well in sunny days. That's the same with the viewfinder as well, actually. It is nice and bright, so it's easy to use even on a bright summer's day. It's a 3.68K dot viewfinder, which actually looks really nice, so the actual resolution is decent on there as well. The camera's using the same battery as the GX9 and the G80, and I've been able to get somewhere around 45 minutes to 60 minutes of 4K video on one charge, which is actually really quite decent for a camera of this size. You know, would I like it to be longer? Of course, I'd always like it to be longer. But actually, to be honest, that has been enough for me to go out and do whatever I'm doing, because that's, you know, that doesn't, 45 minutes doesn't sound like a huge amount of time. But when that's broken up into sort of 3 to 5 minute little clips that I'm doing, that means I'm out and about for a good 2 or 3 hours shooting 4K video before I'm actually having any kind of issues at all. Now the camera itself, the design, the feel, that kind of thing, is a really interesting one. I really like it. I like the fact that it's got a reasonable grip on there for such a small camera. I've got quite big hands, so I quite like that it's a slightly chunkier design. It certainly fits in with other Panasonic Lumix cameras like this, certainly fits into that kind of range. But some people are probably gonna not like how chunky it is. Maybe you want a slightly smaller system. It is actually very, very small. I mean, it's about the size, let's pick up my phone. It's about the size, smaller, I think, than my phone. Obviously, it's a little bit deeper that way, but you know, it's smaller than my phone and it does feel good to hold. Having a little bit extra kind of chunkiness to it does make it feel more ergonomic, at least to me. Now, I do have bigger hands, so I prefer that over those kind of really slimline designs, but it's certainly small enough that you can just pop it in your bag and just take it out with you. It's definitely an everyday kind of camera, travel camera, easy to just pop it, even in a coat pocket, you could probably get away with it. So certainly a nice, small, and actually really lightweight to design as well. The camera itself is super light, and with this little lens on there as well, it's really, really nice system. So ultimately, the Panasonic G100, what do we think? Well, it's obviously a very nice system for vlogging. It's obviously designed specifically with that in mind, designed for content creators and vloggers, and it works really well for that kind of stuff. It's also good though, to be honest, for just general video use. There's a lot of things that you could do with it. It would work great as a B cam to having a main cam doing something else and then having this as a second cam, because there's a lot of nice features. The 4K looks good, the image stabilization is good, that sort of thing. It's perfect for anyone looking to upgrade from something like a smartphone. If they've been doing video on there or vlogs on there, this is absolutely ideal to upgrade to. And also because of the size, the weight, and this little grip I'm using, it's just gonna be very, very easy to set up. It kind of does all the hard work for you. You can of course go into manual modes and control things yourself, but if you don't have to be worrying about all of that, it'll just take care of all of that for you, and you can just get on with making stuff. It's kind of one of those cameras that you can just head out and you know you're gonna be okay, and you're gonna get some good stuff. Now, if you have any questions about the camera, of course, pop them down in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to give it a like, because that really helps us out. Make sure to subscribe as well if you're new, because we've got these sort of things. We've got reviews, we've got tutorials, we've got loads of stuff all the time. I will, of course, see you in the next video. And, as always, thanks for watching.